When Allah blesses you, He knows what you deserve. And He knows what perhaps is better for you right now. Sometimes you and I don't deserve luxury in this world because it may result in us turning away from Allah. So Allah says, I'm not going to give it to you. And you are so upset and angry and praying and asking and saying, oh Allah, I want this, I want this, I want this. Allah says, I know I'm not going to give it to you because I love you. If I'm going to give it to you, it's not going to be good for you. You and I will not have a good relationship. You will forget me. You will go away from me. You are going to drop into sin and that which is deviant, such that in the hereafter, the eternal life will be lost. The best thing, let you not have what you want for a few years, and then when you come to me, I will give you everything you want. Subhanallah. But man, especially those who don't believe,
كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَةَ وَتَذَرُونَ الْآخِرَةَ.
Allah says, nay, you love that which is right in front of you and you forget that which is to come, which is eternal. You love this worldly life such that in it you want what you want. You love this temporary life and you are forgetting that the eternal life that is to come is the reality. It is what you need to work for. What is your wealth going to do for you? Do you know that wealth, when it is given to you, is a very big test from Allah? Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Anfal. O you who believe, O you who believe, do not attempt to deceive Allah or to deceive His messenger. You won't be able to. You are deceiving yourself. What do you think you're doing? O you who believe, be loyal, be faithful unto Allah and His messenger. You say La ilaha illallah. You know it means there is none worthy of worship besides Allah, but you are worshipping everything besides Allah and you are not worshipping Allah. That is the essence of Tawheed. Allah says, don't deceive. Don't attempt to deceive Allah or His messenger. You are not going to get anywhere if you try that. When Allah gives you, say Alhamdulillah. That is why on the day of judgment, a caller will call. Where are those who used to praise Allah upon all conditions? Bring them forth. They deserve VIP treatment here. الَّذِينَ كَانُوا يَحْمَدُونَ اللَّهَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those who used to praise Allah in good condition, in bad condition, it didn't change their relationship with Allah. It made them better. Allah says, we will indeed test you. We will definitely test you with a little bit of the following. Before I mention what Allah says, listen to every single category. It is as though Allah knew, and He definitely did know, but it is as though He revealed the verse for this moment. Allah says, we will test you. بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ, with a little bit of fear. Everyone has a slight sense of fear, some more than others. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we will test every one of you with a sense of fear to a certain degree and a sense of hunger. There are many going hungry across the globe, some because of the lockdown, because of the shutdown, because of the isolation, some because perhaps commodities are not available. So Allah says, some hunger. Some because they cannot eat, there is no one to take care of them. So He starts off by saying, I will test you with a little bit of fear and then with some hunger, al-ju'. وَنَقْصِمْ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ, and the loss of wealth. Many people have lost their jobs, people's income has diminished. Many of us across the globe have struggled in one way or another with our finances. Don't worry, my brothers, my sisters, this is a test from Allah. We will come out of it, and Allah tells you how to come out of it. That's amazing. So if you take a look, Allah says, we will test you with a little bit of fear, with some hunger, with the loss of wealth, the loss of wealth, al-amwal, wal-anfus, and the loss of life. People around you may die, you may lose your loved ones. Allah says, don't worry, take it in your stride. Subhanallah. Allah says, you will definitely lose loved ones. Under normal circumstances, we still lose loved ones. Subhanallah. So when it comes to a situation of this nature, yes, there is fear. Yes, there is loss. Yes, there is a sense of uncertainty. Yes, there is a sense of anxiety. Yes, there is loss in terms of wealth. And yes, there is loss in terms of life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, والثمرات, and loss of produce. Take a look at the farming and the farmers. May Allah make it easy for them. Take a look at the shops in many countries. Some of you are fortunate. And this panic, obviously, it is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested all of us with to varying degrees.
Perhaps it's because of what's going on and the lockdown and everyone's occupied and the days are passing. Guess what? We're almost back into the month of Ramadan. Subhanallah. Now, I want to share with you something amazing. From now, you must start planning what you want to do in Ramadan. And I'm going to tell you what that will do for you. So you must plan how much Quran you want to read, how you want to fast, what salah you are going to read in terms of voluntary salah over and above the compulsory farad salah. You would perhaps get the chance to fulfill a lot more, what you're going to read in terms of books, what you're going to listen to in terms of lectures, what you're going to do to expand your knowledge, what you're going to do in terms of extra ibadah, standing at night, what you're going to do to make this Ramadan more meaningful and productive. Start planning from now. Learning the Quran, reading the meaning of the Quran, trying to understand it, putting it into practice, changing a few things in your life, seizing the opportunity of Ramadan to change completely. Now, the reason why it's very important to make serious intentions already. We don't know if we're actually going to witness the month of Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, let us reach the month of Ramadan. Allow us to witness the month of Ramadan. It's not yet Ramadan. I may die before Ramadan. And that's a reality. I may. Who knows? May Allah grant us all Jannatul Firdaus. Make it easy for us. May Allah give us paradise. But in the case where we don't make it to Ramadan because Allah's taken us away, guess what? You will have a full reward of everything you seriously intended to do, because innamal a'malu binniyat. Definitely all your actions are judged by their underlying intentions. So the hadith says, whoever intends to do good and was unable to do it, Allah writes a reward for that person. Subhanallah. So you will get a reward for whatever you intended to do but couldn't do it. And if you end up doing it and Ramadan comes, you will actually have a multiplied reward in that particular case. Look at the mercy of Allah. So this is why it's always good when you have an opportunity to think about what you want to do, to plan it out in a beautiful way so that you're serious about it, to start thinking about how you're going to be spending Ramadan and inshallah how we're going to be making an Umrah. May Allah open that door for us as well. To say Ameen. Subhanallah. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. And how we're going to be spending the days and ibadah and the salah and reading the Quran, and how many times we'd like to complete the recitation of the Quran, how we want to improve our tajweed and so on. Make the plans from now and start intending these things so that you have a full reward, even in the case where you haven't made it to the month of Ramadan and Allah takes you away before that. And even if you become ill or sick during those days and you're unable to fulfill what you intended to fulfill, you will still have a full reward of what you planned to do. Subhanallah. Amazing, isn't it? So this is the beauty of the month of Ramadan and planning for it. And if Allah allows us to witness Ramadan and we happen to be able to fulfill what we planned, even if it wasn't to the full extent, we will still have a reward and a multiplied reward for everything we were able to do. May Allah forgive our shortcomings and grant us the ability to fulfill this in an amazing way. So one of the most beautiful things we need to start doing now in preparation for Ramadan is to start intending, making niyyah, and start planning and start promising that inshallah I'm going to do this, and inshallah this year I want to do that. I'm going to change my life. I'm going to do this and do that. And you know what? You can start with a few of these things now. Don't wait for Ramadan, because we might not see it. And we still want an increased reward. Show Allah that we are serious about these beautiful promises that we're making. May Allah bless you all. Spread this message far and wide. Because when you spread a message, anyone who follows what you've said, you get a full reward of whatever they've planned to do in Ramadan. How cool is that? Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. May Allah bless you all and grant us all the ability to understand that time is flying. We don't know how long we have to live. People are falling ill, passing away sometimes. Some are surviving. The majority are surviving, but we don't know. Allah has prescribed and written and destined the time that we're going to be leaving this earth for better, for greener pastures basically, for a better place. And we don't know when that's going to be, but inshallah, a true believer looks forward to that trip. أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.